Good, amen. It is
amen.
Good to be here.
Amen.
Good. Yeah. Susan and Alan. Susan Allen, yeah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We're glad to be with you at Christian Life. And everybody said, amen. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Happy Easter. We're glad to be with you. Brother Woody, you're missing a phone. Is that right?
Yeah, I just had here on the piano.
Okay. And, we know how it goes. Yeah, so if anybody sees a missing phone, we know how it is. Please let him know. Please let him know. So we will look for that. We're thankful today to be in his house to celebrate a living, risen Savior. And today we're about to worship the Lord. We do have two birthdays we mentioned for Alan and Susan. We're going to sing to them.
Amen.
And then we're going to lift up the name of Jesus. Let's get excited today. He's worth our best.
Let's go.
Hello.
Well, kind of.
You know, I'm proud to call Lord Jesus Christ my Savior.
Amen.
This has been a fiery week. We, through all our troubles, our trials and tribulations, and Linda here going through about 70 hours of just sitting with her sister, we praise God that he answered prayers.
Amen.
Yesterday. Yes. He give her rest. He give her peace. Because what does God always tell us? Give me your cares.
That's right.
Your cares.
And your burden.
Cast your cares upon me.
And you shall rest.
All your cares upon me.
Amen. Here we go.
Happy birthday.
Here we go. Happy birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
So thankful what he did at Calvary for us, church.
Amen.
We're going to do a hymn song talking about that at Calvary. Mercy there was great. Amen.
Amen.
You're glad he went to Calvary.
Amen.
If he hadn't went to Calvary, we're all doomed. Amen. I'm so glad he went to Calvary, died on that cross for my sins. and everybody else's sins. So we have the opportunity to go to heaven if we choose. Amen. Come on, church. Are you alive this morning?
Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive, alive forevermore.
Did he take care of you this week? We should be all excited at what Jesus done this last week. Amen. Not even thinking about what Jesus is going to do next week. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be great because God is great.
Amen.
God can't fail.
Amen.
We might fail. God cannot fail. And he's alive. You can feel him every day. Don't have to be on Sunday. Don't have to be on Wednesday. You know what? You can go to work Monday morning. There's Jesus. He's there. It is the song I heard this morning. His goodness is running after me. All I have to do is stop. And there's his goodness.
Amen.
All over us.
Amen.
So just praise him this morning. Amen. I don't care if you just wiggle your hand a little bit. I don't care. Praise him. However you feel like praising him this morning. Let's get excited about Jesus this morning. He is ready to move in this house this morning. Let's let go and let God have his way this morning. I told you he told me to get excited. I can't help it.
You know, 2,000 years ago, he carried a cross up Calvary's Hill for us. His body was beaten and broken and bruised. His flesh was ripped from his body.
Yes, it was.
But he carried that cross for each and every one of us.
Yes, he did.
And out of respect for that, I think we all need to be on our feet today, rejoicing and praising him.
Yes. Amen.
Get on your feet, people. Honor God today.
Yes.
Come on.
And I will
kill my trophies at last. I lay down. I will cling to the old running glory.
sing that last verse.
Whatever the devil throws at us, but we've got to keep our eyes on Jesus, not the darts the devil's throwing at us. Keep your eyes on Jesus, and you're going through, period. Keep your eyes on Jesus.
Yeah.
like you mean it, church.
Because he lives.
Let's raise the roof.
He's
there for you. God loves you. God died on the cross for you. He gave you life. He is our life. He is our guideline. He is our director. And someone needs to hear this this morning. Our altars are open, no matter whether we're thinking or whether we're praying. You have an issue. Bring it to the Lord.
And life is worth the living just because he
said, if you have a problem and you have a burden, bring it unto me, and I will give you rest.
It's always open.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Take my yoke upon you and believe me and be blessed. Do you want a blessing today? I got a blessing all week since last Sunday. The fire has been in me deeper and deeper and deeper. What they say in a fight, fight fire with fire. We were talking earlier. I want the fire of Jesus.
Yes.
I want to be able to overcome the fire that the devil puts out there. God gives us the strength. Says, you can step on Satan. You can bound him. What's bound on earth is bound in heaven, folks. Give it to God today.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. You are alive.
Thank you for
and you are greater than anything that would come against us. And in the name of Jesus, we take that stand. And as your word says, we're going to keep on standing. Hallelujah. Can you give him praise in the house?
Yes.
He is worth it. He proves he's worth it. Give him glory today. You are so good, Jesus. Worthy is the Lord. Worthy are you of all that we can give you. The praise, the majesty, the blessing, the honor, the glory. Because the victory is yours. Hallelujah. Glorious is your name.
Yes.
Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you glory. Oh,
greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Greater is he that is in me, yes. Greater is he that is in me, yes. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in this world.
Yes.
Amen.
You are greater, Lord. Greater. Never forget that. It may seem different, but he is greater.
Yeah.
He always will be. Hallelujah. Praise
greatest.
His name.
Amen.
Can you give the Lord praise one more time in the house? Thank you, worship team.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You're so good. Man, thank you, worship team. Did we end up with a special brother or? Okay. All right. He's a good God. He is a good God, and we appreciate him so much in his presence today in this house. So today, no specials this morning, but we hope you can make it back tonight. We got quite a bit of good praise coming to the Lord. If you did come so equipped today for a tithe or an offering, we did give an opportunity for folks to give. Please don't feel any obligation to it, but it is an opportunity today if you're so equipped. We'll call our ushers. If we have some ushers to come for us. He's given us everything. He's given us today life, life. And so today I encourage us, let's grab a hold of that good and give to him as we have the ability to today. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, the name that has lifted us up, because, Lord, you arose, and, Lord, you bring captives, and you've taken us, dear God, and brought us to victory. And today, as we have been given so much, we give to you as we have the chance and the opportunity. We ask that you minister to everyone today who's giving, that, Lord, they will be ministered according to your word and blessed, and those who can't, so that they might be able to give next time, and that every bit of this, every bit will be given for your glory and will be spent the way it should. And we love you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you as you give. God bless you as you give today. If you put up our announcements for us, Brother Gary, pulling some double duty back there. Appreciate him. I just wanted to put up something up there to remind us he's alive, and we celebrate his life today. He is alive, and we look forward to what he's going to do in this time together, continuing, and we also look forward to tonight at 6 o'clock. If you can make it back, we will have our fifth Sunday singing, and so it's not too late. Talk to Brother Terry if you wanted to sing. He's got a list together, but if you want to get on it, he's very much willing to talk to you, ready to talk to you. We have some room if you want to give God praise tonight there at the service. But we got a good group that's going to be coming up. So hope everybody can be here or tune with us on the internet. All right, we do have this coming Friday, a special time of discipleship with Brother Gary and Sister Ruth. That's this coming Friday at 7 o'clock there in Russellville at their house. They'll have a dinner of good chicken and dumplings, and you'll have a dinner, amen, and a dinner of the Word of God, Hebrews 8 through 10. So hope everybody reads up and studies up, because I just encourage you, take advantage of those times. They are precious, and they will build you up. They will build you up. So that's coming up here very soon. We did have a question. This is not on the slate here, but kind of heading in towards our summer plans, and we had a question on VBS. And I believe we had a VBS date that was kind of come up with that we worked on. Did you have that date off your third weekend in July? Third weekend in July, I believe, is what we had down, which is similar to what it was last year. So we do look forward to that. It's a wonderful time. We had an awesome time last year at VBS, and we encourage folks to come and bring some kids with you. It'll be a great time. And also, we do talk about our amusement park trip. That's coming up here soon. If you have dates, it's going to be coming up. We usually do that around the end of May or the 1st of June. And if you have a date that doesn't work for you, please let them know. Aaron usually works on that and sets that up. So Aaron will kind of be working with that. And just let us know if there's a date you can't make it or a day that works better. And we'll start getting that together, too. Because I tell you what, things are coming along. Before you know it, we'll be back. It's going to be very warm indeed. Amen. Praise his name. We're through that. We'll go into his word today. Because I tell you what. We have a lot of things that go on and get celebrated on a day like today, but there's nothing like celebrating his word because it's truly our life. It's our source. I do want to say this, too, for those that got to be here last Sunday, he's a good God. He's a good God. It was a service that reminds us how much he wants to be active in us. He was doing a lot of good work, and he worked through our brother. And I want to remind us today, he is ready to do something again. Special and unique for today. Amen. And not just for the past. We've had three brothers share in the three previous weeks to this one. And I appreciate every one of the words that came in those three brothers. And today we have a word for us today called life wins. Life wins. His life wins. So where I'm going with this today, before I read, I want to kind of encourage us. Jesus is alive. Amen. Jesus is alive. But so oftentimes we in the church can be living like we're half dead. Oh, Lord, help us not to live. If he really is alive and he's inside of us, we should be all alive. We should be fully alive, in other words, not having anything lacking, not having anything halfway done or part ways. Because I tell you what, if we're not careful, even as believers, even that love the Lord, we can find those spots that are missing inside us, that are not alive. Those spots, Lord, I'll let you come here, but oh, I want to kind of leave this on over here, and I'm going to take care of this one myself. I'm going to let this one go for right now. And Lord, help us not to have anything that we let go. I believe the Holy Spirit will speak to you what I'm talking about because he has to me. He's had to me because I can't hold anything back. I can't let it go because we truly need life, y'all. A world needs to see it. So those that knew our sister, and this happened this month, and you'll permit me, Mary Lou passed away. Mary Lou was a lady who sang at this church. If you don't know her, she sang here for many years. She gave God glory in that way. And I began to think about the passing and death, if you will. And I see, and you do too, sometimes the obituary, you'll read them online, you'll see somebody you know in the rustle of paper. I looked and I happened to open up and I saw in the obituary section the picture of a pastor that I knew locally here that had passed away. And we think about those things that can bring a sadness to us if we're not careful. But I tell you one person that wasn't sad about death, Mary Lou. Let me tell you a little bit about Mary Lou. She sang and sang for Jesus, but gradually it came to the point where she was weaker. She couldn't drive. She couldn't come here to church. She couldn't even really stay by herself. And gradually things came. And I was a little bit worried about her that she was going to come to a place where she was going to dread what was next. And she was dreading the death and, you know, the things that were not going right with her. But I believe as time went on, something very different happened. She actually became more confident. She would tell me, we would talk a little bit about the Lord coming. And she would say, I can't wait. I can't wait to go on up. And maybe you know what I'm talking about, because I tell you what, it's good to think about it when we're going to go home to be with him, because death, you see, really isn't death with Jesus. And you say, well, Nathan, that Mary Lou, she was kind of crazy there, wasn't she? And I tell you what, it's not crazy when you're close to life himself, Because what did Jesus say? And I'm not even to my scripture yet. I'm getting there. What did Jesus say? I am the way, the truth, and the life. He is life. And when we have that life, we realize we'll never die. And that's what Mary Lou grabbed onto. And that's what I want to. And I want to see this church grab onto, because he wants to liven every bit of us. Let's go to John chapter 11. John chapter 11, and we're going to begin reading in verse 21. For you see, this is not theoretical. This is real, y'all. You know, I've heard all my life, and I hope you have too, that Jesus died, he rose again. And we hear those, and it's true. But oh, I just pray for us today. It'd be something living, a real living person inside of us bringing victory. All right. We read this passage, and Isabel, appreciate the help. We're going to go down through verse number 26, excuse me. Now Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. In verse 22, but even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha said to him, I know that he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Verse 25, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live. Verse 26, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this? Do you believe this? And that's what I want to leave to you right now. Father God, in the name of Jesus, the name of all names, we ask that you bless and minister in this word today. And that, Lord, in this time we celebrate your life, that, Lord, we will see that come not just as an idea, but, Lord, your word will penetrate all the way down into our hearts and accomplish everything it is sent to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you, and be seated, please. You see, we don't just need life to hear about it as something that's just an abstract concept. Do you understand? It's real. And I'm going to tell just a little bit of my testimony here if you hadn't heard this and maybe hadn't. I was a young boy, and I struggled a lot with fear. And one of the fears that I had was a fear of dying, a fear of passing away. And in that fear that I struggled with, I would feel like, you ever remember an old TV show called Sanford and Son? It was a guy named Red Fox, and he would be like, oh, I'm coming home to you. You know, he was always feigning a heart attack. And so that's how I kind of was with my parents. I felt like whenever I got a pain in here, I was about to die. And you say, well, that was silly. I tell you what, it wasn't silly to me. I was not funning around. I was serious because I was scared. I was scared I was going to die. And then that whole thing kind of carried over. And there was a time, because let me preface this. The devil doesn't wait till you get outside the church to start messing your head. Sometimes he tries to bring death to you in here, in this very building where you are. And don't let this weird you out or something. I just had this voice that I felt like was telling me I was going to die at just a particular certain time. And you know what? That scared me to death. It wasn't from God. It was just whatever in my head. I sat back in that bathroom and I shivered at that. And you know what? I remember things like that pretty well, the things that scared me. And it came up, we're talking 1994, so this goes back a few years, tells you a little bit how old I am. But you go back a few years, and it so happened that I was home alone that night. And it just so happened that I was pretty scared. And I do want to encourage us, though, before I go any further, with what we have, we need to reach out to him. And so that's what I had to do. I blared up there. Remember the show called Home Improvement? I turned the volume on that as loud as I could get it. Maybe I would drown out the death that was coming for me. I was scared, y'all. That's my point I'm getting at. Has anybody ever been scared that it's coming? The Grim Reaper's coming for you, and that your time is just about here. I tell you what, it's a scary thing. But I didn't know a whole lot about God then, but I knew that I better reach out with what I had. I better reach out to him and come to him. And it reminded me, I have a need. I said all that to say this. I had a need. And even though we don't always understand that need, you and I all together, we do still today have a need, but we have a supplier. We have a supplier. And I want to talk about that in just a little bit from this passage, because there's something special from here. Even if we don't know exactly everything, we need to act with what we've got today. Whatever you've got today, the Bible says this, to each one is appointed a measure of faith. Each one, everybody, I don't have that look up, but we can look it up if you need to, but each one has a measure of faith. And wherever that measure is with you today, he's called on us to act on that. Because Martha here, if you look at here, she was struggling. I could see a lot of myself in her, because she was wondering, Lord, she says, Lord, if you'd been here, he wouldn't have died. And if you don't know the story, Lazarus had died. Jesus could have come and healed him, but he stayed where he was, the Bible says. And Lazarus was Jesus' friend. And he said, well, I'm going to stay here. And Lazarus died. And Martha was like, what are you doing, Jesus? Why did you do that? Why did you stay where you were for those days? And the what ifs, I tell you what, we talk about deadly. What ifs are deadly, y'all. What ifs are deadly. And I want to tell you something else is dead: yesterday. Yesterday is gone. You know that old song, yesterday is gone and tomorrow may never be mine? Yesterday is gone, y'all. And we have to realize and understand for us that as we let that go and give that to him and act in faith, that little spark that's in us of faith, we can see miracles happen. Because the troubles that we have in our lives and our church can make us question, where are you, Jesus? If you had only been here, Jesus, this wouldn't have happened. If you had only been working, this wouldn't have happened. And sometimes we struggle. We struggle to believe, even to be saved. And I don't know who's listening to me today and what we need, but sometimes we know we need to turn to God, but we're not where we need to be. Amen. We're not where we need to be. We're struggling to just say, I'm going to lay my life down and actually become born again. Verse 22, Martha, she didn't understand everything, but she still had that small spark. If you want to get down, we don't want to get into heavy theology today, but there was a man, he lived, his name was John Calvin. If anybody's ever heard of him, he said basically, almost like you're kind of fated to do what you're going to do. But there's another man that said, no, it's not quite like that. Because inside of each of us, everyone that is, there's a small spark that can leave out. And God doesn't say you're good and you're bad and that's it. He has that small spark in each of us that can reach out to him and see good things happen. And I believe whoever's listening to me today, there's that small spark in you that you can say, hey, I know what the past has been. I know what the what ifs have been. But I today am going to say that's done. That's over with. And I'm going to reach out to him with everything I have, because he is my life. He is my life. All right, we're listening today. That's good. Keep listening to it here. Because you see, Martha here, she quoted to him a very true doctrine. She had the doctrine down really good. She's like, God's going to give you what you ask, and I know that my brother's going to rise on the last day, but I'm thankful that Jesus isn't just a doctrine today. He is a living Savior. I believe that just in the same way that you see your neighbor sitting next to you, Jesus is here. And Jesus also is here. He's a real person, y'all. And he is able to take us beyond the beliefs and to see those actually come to pass in us, where we really will see those things really happen. And it won't just be a story that we've heard from the day. So I encourage us here that we act on that spark. Because sometimes, if anybody's been there, sometimes your experience will shake up what you believe. You've been, some of y'all, we've been through some things. And that experience can cause you to say, I heard that all my life, Jesus is alive and all that, but I really don't know. I really don't know because I hadn't seen it, my experience isn't there. But I tell you what, if you and I will reach out with that small spark of faith, we're going to have a new experience. That experience that you've had, that experience your loved ones have had, that's the past. And I want to say today is a new day for us, that we step out and act in faith with that spark he's given us, because that's where we're going to see life and we're going to see miracles. Oh, I just encourage us that he gives us faith, each one of us. Each one of us. And no, she didn't understand. Martha, if you read this story, she didn't understand. But she was willing to believe Jesus. There's a little quote I like. A little faith will take our soul to heaven, But a growing faith will bring heaven to our souls. And I encourage us here. I don't want to just stop because many of us, we get saved and we just kind of stay there. But I tell you what, He has more for you. Whoever is listening to this, He doesn't just have you to stop at being born again. He has something more for you. And He has something more for you today. Today. It's not just a past thing. It's not just a future thing. It's something for us today. I want to note here for us, because you know Martha quotes the doctrine to Jesus, but then Jesus reveals Himself that, hey, I know the doctrine. I am the doctrine, and I am the maker, and I will have the final say. I have the final say over life, and He does here in this story. So if you think, sometimes it's good to think big. It's good to think big because we serve a big God. Can you think about the farthest place? They have the telescopes now that are pretty good old telescopes that go way out. And you can see galaxies and clusters of galaxies that go farther and farther. And in fact, it goes so far the telescopes can't even go that far. It's so far. And he every bit of that that you see, every star of the trillions out there, He knows by name. He knows by name. And if you go the other direction, if you go, you know, what is there, 1 quadrillion cells in your body? Each one of those He knows in you and all those He knows. But I tell you what else is amazing. He doesn't just stop there. He doesn't just leave it at, hey, I know that, I made that, I'm that, I am that. He doesn't just let us go and say, well, there you are with your 1 quadrillion cells and go do what you can. He is in us. The Bible says He isn't just out there doing things and then that's it. He sent Jesus to show that He cares. And He's still sending Jesus today to show that He cares. Can you put that verse in Exodus for us, Isabel? Jesus, He met with a man named Moses in a burning bush. It says the angel of the Lord. He talks about that, and it's very clear, it seems, from the scriptures. The Lord Jesus was having a conversation, the Almighty, with Moses here, way back, long before this story we're reading. And it says, and Moses asked Him, who are you, basically? Who are you? And God said to Moses, I am who I am. And He said, thus you shall say to the children of Israel, I am has sent me to you. I am. And if you notice this back in John 11:25, what does Jesus say? I am. There are several I am statements in the Gospel of John. This is one of those statements to tell just exactly who the Almighty is. And it says here, He is life. He is life. But I want to point out to us today, He doesn't call Himself the I was. He doesn't call Himself here the I will be. He's not a has been. He's not somebody who's going to get something later. He is today the I am. I am. Right now, where you're sitting, wherever you're watching this or listening to me, He is able. When we reach out to Him, when we say, hey, I'm tired of the death in me. I'm tired of those spots in me that aren't right. I'm tired of seeing that in my family. When we reach out, He's the God of today. He is the God who is able to do something today. And so someone, I believe, as I was praying for this message, someone has heard it's bad and it's only going to get worse. Oh, they've heard it. You know, you've heard it all your, you know, I'll go to another TV show. You know, Archie Bunker, you ever heard that show goes back? Those were the days. Those were the days. You know, how bad it is now. It's only going to get worse, right? You've heard that. Oh, the misery that's coming here. And that's what you've heard. But I tell you what, He's the same God that brought out the good in you before. Has anybody seen some good in here? Has anybody seen some awesome things that He's done in your life? Did God suddenly quit being God? Because it was today. He did not. He did not. He is God. He is God yesterday, today, and forever. He didn't quit being God just because we had a good service on Sunday. He's not going to just be God for some good service out there. He is God today. And so I believe there's some folks that have come in and they need an encouragement that, hey, it's just, my ministry's not what it used to be. The good things I had are not what they used to be. My body's getting down. My family's down. Everything, the church is down. Whatever's down. But I tell you what, He is still God. He is still God today. He is still alive today. He didn't suddenly go off and quit. In 1966, there was a, you ever heard of Time magazine? You see that on the newsstands. They had a cover on there that said, and it was just in black, nothing else was on there, and said, "Is God dead? Is God dead?" And that, and they got a lot of controversy in those days. But I want to tell you what. He says, "I done been there. I've already been dead. And now I'm alive. And now I'm alive, and I'm not going anywhere. Just because it seems like I'm not there doesn't mean I've gone, doesn't mean I'm dead, doesn't mean I'm quitting. I'm God today, today." And I believe there's some folks that have come in with some dead places, if you will, some of those places that aren't what they need to be. And we're like Martha, we reach out in that spark. You keep on reaching in that spark. Keep on reaching to Jesus because he is the I am. Brother Woody, I hope you found your cell phone. Did you ever find it? You did. Usually it's right where you left it. I'm going to use it. It usually is right where you leave it under your nose, right? It wasn't. Okay, it wasn't this time. My wife is back there, and one time I had her look at all over my house for the keys just the other day, and they were right on the hook, right where I'd left them. So usually we look for things, and look for things that are right under our nose. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I tell you what, Jesus, I believe, he isn't just somewhere far out in those stars. Reach out. Reach out to him. Reach out. And you know what? If you've invited him in, where else is he? He's not just, you know where else he is? But oh, we let it, we don't live that way. We don't live that way. We live like we're dead and not in a good way. We live like that, hey, we don't have the benefits that we have. And I talked a little bit about it on Friday. You and I have good benefits because Jesus died and rose again. You and I have good things. And oh, may we not let the devil tell us it's past. May we not let it tell him that the days of good are past. He is still God. You know, Lazarus, you kind of get that here, you know, hey, he's going to live in the... And then she goes into the future. Hey, he's going to live in the resurrection. I'm looking forward to heaven. Is anybody looking? We talk about a life. We got a lot of folks we're going to see there in heaven. But as I want to remind us, what is he God of today? And he wants to bring heaven, not just then, he wants to bring it here, here. He asked Martha if she believes this. And then verse 27, I do read this for us. And she said to him, this is John 11:27. She said to him, "Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is to come into the world." Amen. We need some folks like Martha. They've seen those dead places a long time. They've seen those places that are not what they need to be in their hearts, in their families, in their bodies. They've seen it a long time. But they say, "I still believe. I still believe he's God. I still believe he's good. And I still believe there's something good that's going to happen to me. And not just in the future. Today. Amen. Today. Today." All right. I just encourage us. Act on that spark that you've been given from the Lord. And you remember all the way back, I don't have the verses here, but remember all the way back at the women at the tomb? We hear this a lot, the resurrection. The angels come and say, you know, he's not here, he is risen. Amen, remember that? You know what a lot of people would have said? Show me the proof. Show me the money here, if you will. Where's this at? I don't see anything here. You know what I'm talking about? But what did those women do? They believed. They believed. I remind us of that. Whatever that spark is he's given us, step out and act on that. Because when you're willing and you and I are willing to step out and act on that, we're going to see more. Amen. He is not the God of just where we are. We're going to see more. Amen. We're going to see that good. We're going to see life come to those dead places. Somebody needs to step out and praise God anyway. Praise God anyway, even though you haven't seen what you need to. And I tell you what, as the preacher said one time, when you catch fire, a lot of people are going to come around and watch you burn. Miles around, they'll come and watch you burn how much God has done for you, because somebody needs to see somebody step it out. Because it's one thing to praise when there's, you know, the life is there, you know, God's working and doing amazing things. It's one thing to praise then. I tell you what, it's something else when you and I step out and say, "Oh, there's some dead places. There's some stuff I don't understand. But I'm going to step out anyway, and I'm going to say, he's alive today, and he is life in me, and I've got something good ahead." And if we step out in that, I tell you what, we're going to see more. We're going to see what we're missing. Well, how do I do that? How do I see it? I tell you what, Mary and Martha and the whole crew here, they keep hanging out with Jesus. So I encourage us, act on that spark and keep on hanging. Keep on hanging with Jesus. verse 39 and 40. We continue in the story. There's a lot here. The famous verse, Jesus wept. He very much cares. He very much was upset about what was going on then, the death and all that, and the people's lack of faith. John 11, 39. We'll continue in the story. Jesus said, take away the stone where Lazarus was. Take it away. Martha, the sister of him who was dead, said to him, Lord, by this time there is a stench, for he has been dead 4 days. In verse 40, Jesus said to her, did I not say to you that if you would believe, you would see the glory of God? Amen. Keep on hanging with him. Keep on hanging with him. I tell you what, if we look at the rules, sometimes the rules of our lives will say they stink. You know that? We hadn't always followed and done what we need to do. Does anybody know we got some stench coming from us in the spiritual we're talking about? That we're not exhibiting what we need to. And we realize that that's there. We realize that we have a mess. Maybe souls of our family or our health or our finances or our nation. We see those dead places there. We see that stink that's there. But I thank the Lord as we stick close to Jesus, he speaks that life into them. Amen. He speaks life into everything that needs life today. Keep hanging out with Jesus. You know, it's like, hey, he knew every decomposing organism that was in that tomb. He knew it all. And he says, hey, I wrote the rules. Stick with me. I wrote the rules. Stick with me. Keep working with me because I have the life to speak if we'll only believe and act on that. And so I want to read this because this is precious to us here. Verse 43, if you could put that up for us, Isabel, verse 43. Now when Jesus had a short prayer, he communed with his Father, and he says this, and now when he had said these things, he cried out with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. Verse 44. And he who had died came out, bound head and foot, with grave clothes, and his face was wrapped with cloth. And Jesus said to them, loose him, let him go. Is there anybody God's bringing through something right now? Is there anybody God's working through some things? I want to encourage you. He doesn't bring us just to let us go. He still has a word for you. He still has that word for you. And he has, if we'll let him, the final word for us. He says, Lazarus, come forth. And I believe for us today, he is calling to all that. He's calling and say, Nathan, come forth. Let that dead go. Don't hold on to that anymore. And guess what happens? He heals us. He heals us to the uttermost. Oh, I encourage us that our prayers, our faith, our words should be full of life. For it's like we said at the beginning, life wins. A lot of times we speak death. The life is what wins. Oh, let that life win in us today. Speak that life here. And I just encourage us, as we hang on, Christian life will see miracles. This church is going to see good things. You know, we saw good things Sunday, and God was blessing a lot of people. And I just encourage you, stick with Jesus. Keep hanging in. A service is not an end unto itself. A good thing that God does, it's not that just kind of like a, well, that's a good kind of end to our story, and now we got to go on back to Monday morning where it's the way it always has been. I tell you what, he wants to see a building up of our story. He wants to see a building up of Christian life. That, yeah, we have people that are, God's bringing in the power, but I tell you what, there's miracles that are happening. There's victory that's happening. That there's people being saved and delivered. What did Jesus do? Delivered them from demons. You know, demons didn't just take a break just because it's now. Did you know that? There's a today that the enemy works. And that's not to scare anybody. It's just to say there's a work that needs to be done. There's a work that needs to be done in this house. And for us, I want to say this. God has miracles here. If we'll only step out and believe. And it doesn't have to be even in this house. He can work through you. Did you know that? He can work through you. Stepping out to praying for those people. Bringing life to what's dead. Because so oftentimes, oh, we have ideas. There's competing ideas. But people need to see life. They need to see life. And if what we say is true, and I believe with all my heart that it is, that Jesus is alive in me, they can see what they need to see that's dead in them come to life. Come to life. You see, Lazarus was raised up. And I thank the Lord for that. But in the natural, he died again. Did you know that? He had to go back into the tomb another time, and he didn't come back out. That happened. But I'm thankful. Like we already said, Life itself died. Life himself died. But he didn't stay dead. Acts chapter 2 in verse 23 and 24. As we look to wind this down for us here. Him, Jesus, being delivered by the determined purpose and foreknowledge of God, you have taken by lawless hands, have crucified, and put to death on that cross. But verse 24, the Bible says this, but whom God raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be held by it. I thank the Lord that he did the impossible. He was willing to be life. He is life itself. And he was willing to die for us, but he doesn't stay dead. And for us, he rose again. And even though Lazarus died, Jesus did not and will not stay dead. And I believe for him living in us, we're going with him too. And we're going to be alive too. And not just in heaven, but I believe today. And whatever's missing, whatever's not where it needs to be, he wants to quicken that up. And I just encourage us, act on him today. Act on what he's done for you today. And then step out and keep on stepping out. You stay on that. You say, it's not going like I need to, Nathan. It's not going. I've done what I need to, and it's not. We hang on with Jesus. Sometimes we got to get some stench out. We got to open up the tomb and just be willing. Hey, I'm going to take a step of faith anyway. And when we do, we're going to see that word come forward. Hang in there. Don't quit till the miracle happens. Hang in there today, y'all. I remember there was a time in my life. I'll share this real quick. There was a time in my life. I had to come to, it was like the weight of the world. I don't know if anybody's ever been there, but it's like the weight of the world has been getting down and down, and I knew I wasn't where I needed to be with God. And I didn't even know, I still was pretty young. I didn't know what to say to God. And you just come to him. You just get on your knees sometimes. You got nowhere else to go. You get on your knees, and you have to say, Lord, I don't even know how to talk to you. I don't even know. I've tried to pray. I've done everything I know to do, and I've tried. But I've got to come here and say it's not what it needs to be. And I come to you, Lord, and I lay it down. And you know what? It isn't something that's just a theory out there or just an idea. It's something real. He really came to me. He really came to me, and he really changed me, and he took that weight off of me. I know he did. And I believe he's doing that for some here. And I believe there's more work on that needs to be done here in this house. He needs to take some burdens down. I encourage us today, just like he breathed life, I know, into me, he wants to breathe life into everybody. Life, because you see, life wins. And I see also Christian life wins. Did you know that? This church is a winner, y'all. We are winners. We are not losers. We are winners for your finances. Oh, sometimes we have those dead places in our money. Anybody know what we're talking about? He breathes that life. Just like he breathed into Adam, he breathes that life into the finances as we have that heart and give to him our very best. He gives to us family. Health, all those things that he wants to breathe life into, he has that for us. And I can invite the musicians to come back up. I believe there might be some that they're not quite where they need to be with God. They've heard about the life all the time, but they haven't really accepted that life. Today's a good day. Can anybody say amen to that? If you need to accept him, this is a good day. And I believe there's some that, as I was talking, there's some places that are just not, they're not quickened, if you will. They're dead. They're dead. And it seems hopeless. But today, we serve a God who raises the dead. And he wants to do that in you. And if there's anything in our lives that's not pleasing, he wants to have that. If there's anything in our families that we're believing for, he wants to have that too. Spring to life. I want to pray for us today. Can you come and don't let this just be that guy up there in the white coat is talking. I would encourage you. Can you come to him today just like he has the life that you need? Father God, for anyone that's under the sound of my voice, I pray that you in the precious power that you give, dear God, the Lord, you will reach down and reveal how much you love and how much life that you want to give. If there's anybody, dear God, that's not where they need to be with you, I pray, Holy Spirit, you speak and bring to life what needs to be. Because, Lord, you are not a dead God, and you don't want to see the dead around. You want to see life come. Reveal that. Do what I can't do. Reveal that to everyone listening. And also, Lord, I pray for anyone that's got something going on. They don't see a hope. You are that life for them, Lord Jesus. You're that life, dear God, for that dead area. Can I ask if there's nobody looking around at this point? Just if you bow your heads, close your eyes, talk to Him. Is there anybody that would say, Nathan, I'm not where I need to be with God. I'm not sure if that trumpet sounded today, I would be ready. You lift up your hand and say, I need Jesus today. I'm just not sure. I need to make sure and make it right. God bless you. God bless anybody else. Thank you, Jesus. I'm just not sure. God bless you. I'm just not sure today. I've heard it all my life, but I'm just not sure, and I want it to be right. Father, there were two hands that were lifted up, and I just can't thank you enough for those hands that say they need you, because, Lord, I can't do it. There's not a person in here that can, but you are life. And I just pray as they admit, dear God, admit they need you, admit their sins to you, and confess you, dear God, that, Lord, as they confess openly with their mouths, they will be saved. And, dear God, you will bring that salvation and make it real to them. And, Lord, I can't thank you enough for it. I can't thank you enough, dear God, for making them right. That when they leave this place, dear God, after talking with you, they'll know where they're going. They'll know the life is in them. And they're not going to be the same. Thank you for it, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. I just encourage those that lifted their hands, just believe Him. Act in that faith today. Talk to Him right now, and He will change you. Can everybody... He says in the words, He's looking for that one more than the 99. If anybody knows what I'm talking about, He's looking for the one that needs help. For those who lifted their hands, can you pray for them today? Lord, we intercede today. Oh, we intercede because the enemy fights hard. But we rebuke the power in the name of Jesus. And as the word says, the Lord rebuke you in Jesus' name. That, Lord, for these that have lifted their hands, they won't be held back, dear God. But life is going to come to every part. Every need that they have, life is coming. And we intercede for these today, dear God. Because you told us to pray, and we believe and intercede. That, Lord, we're going to see victory for them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. This next part I'm going to pray, I would raise my hand, and I will raise my hand now. Is there those areas in your life, maybe in the body of believers, that you say, I want to see life in that. Can you just raise your hand to Him? I need some life. I need some life in that area. I need some life for my family. I've been talking to that family member a long time, and it just seems dead. It seems cold. I need some life. Does anybody with an uplifted hand say, I need life to come in that? Anybody, come on. You're not lifting it for me. You're lifting it to Him. I need you, Jesus. I need some life in me. I need something more than I've got now in my heart, in those places that maybe I'm not letting you reach, Lord. I know you, but I'm not letting you in all the way, and it's not good. It's not right. Oh, Lord, you see every hand. Oh, you see us lifted up to you. We need you, Lord. What's dead, bring to life today. Let this not just be a time we think, happy thoughts, and then that's it. But Lord, you will bring real and true and good life to every one of us, and every part of us, and everyone that we love, and every sick body, dear God. Oh, there's some sick people, dear God, that are here in this house. And Lord, you give life. And I pray you do it in Jesus' name. Give some life to some sick bodies. They may not be here even in this church, but Lord, the people that will see them will be here. Empower them to pray with life for these that are sick. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We love you for it, for doing it in Jesus' name. If you had the ability, could you stand in the house today? If you don't, that's okay. But we just ask you to come to Him. They're playing a song you may not know, but if you do know it, you're welcome to sing it with them as they roll through that. We sing a brand new song.
And now I see.
Come to the altars. That's why they're here. If you need prayer, come down. We'd love to pray with you. The Bible says, if there's any sick among you, call for the elders and all of old. We'd be glad to give hands on prayer. In the meantime, let's worship. Thank you, Jesus.
To wash my sins
away. If I could get some of the brothers. Anybody else, come on down. In the meantime, just bless him. Worship him. Oh, the blood. Sister, dear God, as she quotes the word, that Lord, this family will have life so they can share it. Just a building, a growing work, dear God, that is just going to overflow into Lord, dear God, we believe for it. Your word is true, dear God, and your word is right. We stand on that word, or two or three are touching any one thing. Places there in that heart, dear God. In any heart, in those places that seem like there's no hope, dear God. Life, fullness, glory into these in Jesus' name.
Father, Lord, we lift Laura up to God now, right there where she's at, Father. The Lord, your perfect will working in Laura, Lord, doing in her what she cannot do for herself, Father, the Lord. God, we pray, the Lord, right now for anointing upon her from the top of her head to the ends of her toes, that you will make yourself real to her. Laura knows who you are, Father. She has felt your very presence, God. Lord, all we can say is to ask her to live and not die in the name of Jesus. Lord, we claim this right now over her, Father, the Lord, and God, that you will send her a hope to Lord, and God, that this is not the end, and God. It's not over to you. Say it's over, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We agree. We agree that when they go back to see Lord, Lord God, they'll see a difference. They'll see a difference. We believe.
Jesus.
Our sister here is standing in for a dear pastor's wife that many churches are praying for. She has 6 months to live, the doctors say. Remember, we serve a God of life today. We serve a God of miracles today. And Father, we agree for this dear saint. She believes you, dear God. And Lord, we pray as a testimony to a lot of people that are seeing and watching her life, that you show that life into her body in Jesus' name. Heal her, dear God. And when she goes to the doctor, there'll be a difference, a miracle difference in her. We believe it, dear God, and we stand in a faith and an agreement for our sister, dear God. Oh, that she's battled the enemy, dear God. Greater is he. Greater is he in us than the he's in the world. As Lord, your word says, dear God, you give us power over all the enemy and nothing shall harm us. And we believe this for our sister. And as Ruth stands in, we believe that to see the and hear the good that you're doing in Jesus' name.
Keep it up, church.
Amen. Any other that want to come and join him? Joseph's asking for help with those dead spots. Father, I agree in the name of Jesus that what's been told to him, there's nothing good for him. There's no hope for him. And Lord, you have a different word for him today, dear God. And that's a word of life. It's a word, dear God, of victory. And Lord, it's a word of healing. As he lays that down, dear God, and let's invite you in, dear God, you're not going to turn him away. For what we hunger and thirst after righteousness, we shall be filled. Thank you.
Oh, Lord. Lord, I pray that you take the burdens off of this man's shoulders, Lord. I know you can and I know you will. Yes, Lord, this man has deep dark spots, Lord. I pray that you shine the light on him, Lord, and let your light shine on him. Shine it deep, Lord. Take care of the dead spots that he has, Lord. And I just pray in Jesus' name that you heal this man of all of his dead spots, Lord. You just send your spirit so deep into him, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, that we thank you that you brought this man to us, dear Lord, and that he's going to follow you wherever he goes. You will be with him wherever he is. You shall be there and you shall take over for him, Lord. You shall give him the peace that he needs. And you will, yes, there's only one way to go, and that's forward. And it's an easy step to take. One step at a time, you shall be with him. That you want him to be, Lord, and I just pray this with all my heart that I have, soul that I have for you, Lord, and just cleanse this man's soul through all the darkness, and whatever he has done, whatever it's been, it is gone, it is history, it was yesterday, yesterday is gone, it is now, tomorrow we do not know, but yesterday is gone, it's history, it is what the man that you will be now, will from forward on, you shall be man of God that he wants you to be, that your light will shine when you walk into a room. People will know that you have changed. In Jesus' name I pray, this man will be a man of God that he never thought that could be happening, Lord. Your family will shine upon you and they will love you because of the changes that you've made and that has come through you.
Lord. We will hear the word, we believe the report of the Lord. Amen. Praise his name. Hallelujah. What to say for those on the internet out there. We love you. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Happy Easter. We pray God's blessings as you go forward. We hope to see you tonight. God bless you. Hallelujah.